And today we're going to do a Q&A. We have asked you guys some questions and we're going to answer them as truthful as possible. And if we don't feel comfortable answering, the code word is I plead the fifth.
We're doing this video because just something for the time being, get the views up, see what you guys think. So don't take anything personal.
A lot of people love us to get there.
I know.
It's true.
It's the worst, you know, dog.
Not to forget, we're the three Leos, you know, so I actually don't even know how we're friends anyway.
Exactly. But yeah. When you hear nice words like, yeah, well, that's fake.
Anywho.
Anyway, let's start with a question. Okay. The first question is, how long have you known each other? So, first time I met these guys was in year six when these two and Jason were laughing at me in the playground. I was a big joke. Then I met Portia at school, and then I met Tyra. I met Tyra at school too.
For those who don't know, me and Tyra are cousins, so we've known each other from the womb.
Yeah.
Me and Quanique have known each other since year seven, officially 2008. So that's about 11 years. Yeah. 11 years, and we're still going strong.
All our families are connected, so we were connected.
Second question. Your turn. You choose the second question.
Okay, then who was your first love and why did it work out?
I can't go first. I don't wish to disclose who my first love was for just confidential reasons, and it didn't work out because everyone was involved, you know, people just talk.
My first love was James. The white boy James from school. Yeah, I used to like my white boys. I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, I did. Now I like my blacks.
My first love was a person called,
Ricky.
We're still good friends till this day, but the reason why it didn't work out is because he's a cheat.
You know what? I just don't understand.
Exactly.
He's gonna be watching this, and I hope you don't hear your
arm. He's a cheat.
Oh, Faye, come on with this.
You know what? Next question.
Your turn. Next question.
Okay, the next question is, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? In the next 5 years, I see myself with my own business. I study events management, and I would hopefully like to be putting on events all over internationally, you know. Yeah,
that's good. Next 5 years, I would want to be a mediator. I want to counsel people relationship wise. I chat a lot, I talk a lot, so you know, that's the only reason why I'm going into that. Dance failed, so let's just, you know, talk the things. Yeah. Next question. Who gets the most attention out of the three of yous? Tyra.
Nah, it's more Quanique.
It's more Tyra?
It's no, more Quanique.
It's Tyra for me. And I knew everyone was going to say me.
It's between these two guys. It's between these two. I'm off the radar.
I feel like people only know me because of my one friend. So, really, if you know Justin Arado. But that's the only reason why people...
One more time.
Black girls, make up noise. This is the real us, you know, and don't even watch the video for like, oh, they're just doing it for the video. If you're not us, this is
actually us. Okay.
Exactly. Go on.
Okay, the next question is, how do you find being a young parent?
I don't have no kids. Thank you. I want them now.
How do I find being a young parent? I think it's really great because when you're young, you get to grow with your child. Like, we're growing together and it's good. And also, yeah, it's just really good. I like it. I feel like I had my child at the right time. Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like I had my child at the right time, but then again, there's like perks with it. Like, some days I'll be feeling so down, like I can't even fake. Like, sometimes I just feel like, oh my god, what have I got myself into?
It's true.
But when you really think about it, you've got a wonderful child. Like, you're gonna look at that child and they're gonna do things, and it's gonna be like, oh my god, that's me. And you know, one thing, if you're gonna have a child at a young age, make sure you've got a support system.
Yeah, you need that support system around you, because times can get very hard and you've been very tired, like me.
Okay, next question. Who's next? You.
Is it me?
Yeah.
Name two worst stages in your life and two of the best stages. One of the best stages, I would say, was actually just being able to give birth, like experiencing that. Like, obviously it's painful, but I'm glad I was able to experience that.
Okay, next question. What's your guys' zodiac sign?
Leo.
Yeah.
If you had to pick a moment in your life to relive, what would it be?
To relive?
A moment I pick in my life to relive, is
really? Nah, you can't even give me a
great question. I think the moment I pick in my life to relive is like similar to what Kwani said, is a high school memory, like something in high school, like just when everyone was simply laughing, like everything was so funny, something like that. Mm-hmm. I would love to relive that.
Just being younger again, like,
growing
up.
We're just 21.
I know. I know, really. I'm saying, like, I don't lie. Exactly. But listen. Why? All I can say is, all I just know, independent life is serious. That's all I'm telling you. Me and me, I feel live.
Right. What's one thing that you would change about yourself?
Change. I don't really like my nose.
Who troubled this girl?
So I'd fix my nose. I wouldn't have a nose job, so don't go that far. If I could change it, I would, and I know I can, but I'm not going that far. But yeah, I would change my nose.
One thing I would like to change. I know it's nice being kind to people, but I would like to change my kindness sometimes, because sometimes people take your kindness for weakness, and that's something that's happened a lot in my life, like from growing up. But yeah, mm-hmm. Being nice to people, but you know, there's limits. Just know your limits.
Not just dog.
Mm-hmm. Okay then, let me see. Three males that have had an impact in your life.
Three males that had an impact on my life. Is my dad, which is a good impact because he's always been there, and I was a daddy's girl. I'm not so much one now, but yeah, I love my dad. Through my oars, I would say the partner that I'm with now, because he really changed me for the better, and my child as well. My child really took me to a place that I've never been in before. So yeah.
I'm trying not to be outrageous on this video, you know. So, for me, I would say my Uncle Andrew. Loving to death do us part. Oh, God. I have a friend, male. Not going to say the name. But they must know who they are. They teach me a lot mentally and emotionally. And I feel like... yeah, let me just done it there, because if I go in, I'm gonna be checking for third days. Male. Third male, I don't have one.
Three males in my life. Number one would have to be my granddad. If you know my granddad, my granddad's been picking me up from school, bossing me in the back of my head since I was about, three. One time he'd give me a piece of drawing because I wanted to walk over the bridge, but he was walking out front of school. Okay, I'm just gonna leave that there. But my granddad, I love my granddad.
Next question is, have you ever been cheated on and how did you handle it?
I'm gonna
say one thing. If there's anyone watching this laughing like, you have been.
You too?
Not, I don't know of it, you know, so I'm gonna say no, I haven't been cheated on. And so, yeah, not that I know of, no.
Why?
No, I shouldn't laugh.
Why, matey?
Full on matey, over it, just done it. I'm full on matey, I was, and that was a laugh and guan. But guess what? The boy still come back. Thanks.
Well, me, I've been cheating. I'm not guilty for cussing. I have been cheated on. I'm so open about it.
It is what it is.
Why? Like, I've been cheated on.
I'm over it anyway. I really am. Next question.
How was your childhood?
My childhood was mad. Like, I loved it because it was literally all about cousins.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when you was a child, it was all about cousins, and my family's very tight, so it was just like funny. And then friends as well, like, just bare laughing. Like, I don't laugh how I used to laugh, you know what I mean? So my childhood was just crazy. Like, every day belly's hurting you because you're laughing so much.
My childhood beaten. Beaten. That's all I knew. Beaten. If it wasn't from my mom, it was from the uncle. If it wasn't from the uncle, it was this. Beaten. Oh, God.
No.
Please. Someone said, let me see. What's the most embarrassing thing that's happened to you?
I
know how to answer that, actually. Now, I was at a house party. I was drunk like a skunk. I was 14, drunk like a skunk. Nobody was watching me, Porsche, my
own. Like, oh, yeah?
Hold on. Porsche alone, you know.
I watched the whole household. Bearing in mind, everyone's drunk but me. I got water dashed in my face 2 times.
Anyway, I'm drunk like a skunk. I'm wearing like purple shorts and I'm in the bath. Sprawl out. like that, basically. And then after a while, the picture went viral.
I know.
Like, I was getting digged out. I never had no shorts. Nasty.
I remember that, actually.
Me that can't take embarrassment. Jesus Christ. I wanted to ball. Listen, and I know some of you have still got that picture, you know, deep down in the camera roll. But, yeah, that was embarrassing for me. Not the most embarrassing, but that's the one that I can remember.
Most embarrassing moment for me, I think it was one day when my mum told me, come home from school. Like, everybody knows, when your mum tells you to come home from school, you're not going home. You're going to town, you're going to West Brom, wherever you're going.
Yeah.
So I thought I was big and brave. Now I've gone to West Brom, come back home, my friend's walking me to the door. I'm saying, yeah, you can come in and chill for maybe like 20 minutes, whatever. Soon as I got to the door and opened the door, bang, my mum, right in my face. My head flew back and licked the door shut. My friend just walked up and me, Shanice, you know what you did, you're water.
Oh, man.
So
she's
supposed to be better.
She was supposed to wait.
No way.
She had the blonde as well.
No. I'm not taking the embarrassment, you know.
Bang me in my face.
Yeah, so.
I think I'm going to pass on that question because I can't think of the most embarrassing time.
Okay, next question.
Have you ever been the other woman?
Yes. Matey. I'm sorry, talking.
No candle, Linda sitting there.
Matey.
I haven't.
I have.
Matey.
I have, but boys are liars. Let me
and
tell
if
you
I have, I probably didn't know.
I know. Best
you're just... talk like, but not that I know of. Like, it's I wouldn't do something like that, like, if
no.
I knew.
No, I'd rather not know, but then again, you have girl, I laugh, fella. I've been the laugher, so if you're with your man, I'm laughing.
I've never done that, guys, but I have been the other woman and I've had to give him back. You know that you are.
I'm not crying.
Anyway, sorry. Next question. Anyway, go on. Is it me?
Yeah.
Is it me? Okay, then.
I feel like this video is going to be about this.
I know. Is the barriers with having male friends in a relationship?
What do you mean?
You're asking me like I give myself the question.
Mm-hmm.
I have male friends anyway. Loads of them. If you don't like it, bite it. Oh. Anyway, but... depends. Like, if I'm in a relationship, my man has to know who my main ones are from the start, and if there's any others at the background that you're not aware of, pull me up, put me in my place.
Yeah. Oh. Tie me up.
Hello? No. Okay. Yeah, basically.
I'm not going to answer that question. I plead the fifth.
Yeah.
Oh my god,
I went out yesterday and I pushed the boy in his back and he went, oh!
No. Okay then.
If you had to keep three friends, who would it be?
Tyra, Conique and Savannah.
Take me out. I plead the fifth.
You know what?
Next question. I'm over this video already.
I'm skipping. I'm on set. How much children do you want? I just want two. I've got one already and I just want two. I'll buy a girl and I'll be happy with that.
Yeah. Two or three. Yeah.
I think three's
a handful if you ask me. Because in the car's full. But there's no space for anyone else.
God.
I'm thankful for the one.
Oh God.
Sorry.
Okay.
Me, if you know my daughter and you've seen her run, stop. We have another one.
Have you ever been in an abusive relationship? No, don't mean just getting beaten.
Physically, mentally, emotionally, socially.
Okay then. And it don't have to be a relationship with a man, you know, it could be a friend. Now, I would say mentally, that people really know how to trick and kill me, you know, people know. And I retaliate to everything, so, yeah, mentally I have, because they know, they know how to use their brain and you know who you are, right? Thank you.
No, I haven't.
Personally, for me...
Where's your favourite vacation and why? If you know me, when I come back from Jamaica in 2015, I ain't stopped talking about it. Nothing else can top, nothing else will ever top. But yes, Jamaica was the best holiday I've ever been to.
Yeah.
It was just great. Like, it was just love, the vibes, everything.
So after that's me twice, Jamaica. I haven't went nowhere else in the world, just Jamaica. I fly out every year and I'm going to keep flying out every year and I'm going to keep going. I'm with my Ifri, thank you.
The furthest I've been on holidays was... You see, you're laughing already because you know I'm going to say it.
Oh.
So guys, I was supposed to go away and basically we got to the airport...
No, that should be a story time.
He's been on holiday.
How do you deal with negativity? I would say how I deal with negativity is don't stoop down to that person's level. Just stay positive, because you stooping down to their level, you're not going to get anywhere. And always pray for people, because you never know what people are going through. Sometimes people are negative, they generally can't help it. So just pray for them.
Anyway, sure. I feel like we need to take a quick break. So
come back to the question.
Peace.
Hey,
goddamn serious. Me dad them not nervous. Let the cool again come on. What?
She's getting the list from Jamaica.
I think my favourite song. I wouldn't say my favourite song. If I actually had to pick a song that I play every single day, is. What's it called again?
Oh my gosh, I forgot. Busy Signal Stairs, so that will forever be my song. Forever.
What's it called? Oh, Chronic Skanking Sweet. Every morning, I play the song, Father God, thank you for earth and life. Thank you, right. Next one. Call it a night. Listen, if you know the video's too long, blood, we have to cut it. So, just being real and true. And if you was wanting more excitement, that's not what we gave there.
Anywho, you'll have to tune into the next video.
Like, comment, and subscribe. And comment underneath the videos that you would like to see us doing.
Mm-hmm.
True.
Yeah. If you're ready, let me know, because it's whatever.